Hey everyone, welcome back to another episode of Darkness Falls. It is Horde Night here. I've been kind of puttering around doing a few things here, destroying stuff. Slowly replacing this very dangerous glass with some wood bars here so I can shoot through it and not fall through it because like it's almost impossible to see that glass. So yeah, that's dangerous, especially knowing me over here. I can fall into it. Look at this. There's a spot right here. I guess I... Maybe this is glass. Let's find out. Oh, it is too. See? See how hard it is to see if it's glass. Anyway, I've been working on this place here in between episodes. Put about 10-15 minutes into it here, I think. Been taking stuff out, and one other thing I want to do too is replace all these windows around with bars. I think that'll actually work out well because I totally forgot about the birds, and I think the birds can get through this pretty damn easily. The bars might slow them down just a bit. Hard to tell, though. I guess we'll find out. Now, I have no idea what time it is, guys. I'm assuming it's getting around there, maybe around 1700, around 5 o'clock. So we still got a little bit of time to kill here. I really don't want to wander too far from our horde base. Now, tonight, our tactic is pretty much going to be trying to keep the building standing and trying to keep the zombies away from me instead of a lot of trying to take out the zombies. Like I said earlier in the episodes, this time around, I really want to be on top of keeping my game stage down so I can get everything together to be able to survive the later game stage hordes because they just get pretty damn crazy. Now, the one other thing I need to do is we need two more skill points here. If we go and take a look at my laborer class and advanced engineering here, we can reduce crafting time of forge recipes by 20%. That's insane. Mining helmet recipe, that'd be cool too. Reduce crafting time of workbench recipes by 20%. Unlocks workbench and dart trap recipes. So dart traps would actually be very useful for these hordes, especially early game, and it'd be nice to get the workbench. So all we need is two more skill points, I do believe. Yes, we have to have the first one done here. So awesome. Now the other thing we did finish was our quest here for mechanic. We've finished mechanic 5 of 6. I just scrapped some stuff down. And then I happen to have all of this stuff in my inventory, so it just chained right through the quest. So we have both of our mechanic and our laborer quest done, which unlocks the skills here. So let's take a look at mechanic as well. We have 3 of 5 together, so this unlocked. We have harvest 20% faster, 40% faster, 60% faster, 60% more resources. And I can get the steel club, which I don't have quite yet. But then you get robotics inventor and grease monkey too. We can actually get our bikes and stuff together here. And then master mechanic unlocks all the other cool stuff. All the other cool vehicles and whatnot. So a lot of work to do. Mechanics workbench, also very handy. Mini bike master, we can craft mini bikes and bicycles. So we can also take a look into this, but I would really rather get the guppy cart together. Maybe it won't vibrate and run so funky this time. I heard it's been fixed. Looking at you, guppy. Alright guys, well, I'm going to spend a few more minutes here tearing down this building and doing some upgrades, and we'll see you right before the bell tolls. Oh, you know what? I almost forgot, guys. I almost forgot to put all our torches. We made 11 of them. It definitely cost us, and I almost forgot to put these damn things out. Whoops. Okay, let's pick up some of these, too. I don't really need to be wasting this much wood early game. We don't even have a permanent way up here. We've just been nerd pulling up. So that's a little dangerous, especially if I fall down on Horde Night. But we'll build a stair system up ASAP. Alright, so I'm going to, I think, I'll probably put these up a little higher here. There we go. I'm going to be sticking, I think, sticking around this area for the most part, I believe. And then I got to try to remember to take these down as soon as Horde Night ends, because I really don't want to attract a ton of screamers. So I'm going to throw one on each opposite wall here, just kind of randomly light up the other areas. And we should be good to go as far as lighting goes. There we go. So 7 Days of Die is just naturally a dark game, guys, and sometimes you just gotta deal with it. I mean, you see pretty much what I see, so if you're having a hard time seeing, I probably am too. There we go. Right on, let's close the door just for good measure, and I'll get back up top. Now, I'm thinking the main entrance I'm gonna put right above this little patio here in this big area, because that's a nice wide big window right there, and I keep going in through these small ones, but that's something we can look into the future. I wonder how trash this building is gonna get tonight. It's gonna get pretty insane, I think, from what I hear from other people, but then again, People told me Alpha 19.2 was pretty crazy, and I was actually kind of disappointed. Well, not really disappointed. We held together well, so, I mean, it worked, but wasn't as crazy as I thought it was going to be. Oh no, guys, it's here! Horde Knight is here! I was actually looking for my 9mm ammo. I couldn't find it, but where are these guys all going to be coming from here tonight? Let's take a look here and cross my fingers and hope I remember to turn it on to 8 max and not 64 max Horde Knight, because if it's 64, I have a feeling this place will get absolutely destroyed. Okay, where are these guys all coming at? Okay, looks like actually they're coming over from this side. We're still pretty controlled here, which I like. Okay, I didn't get all this glass here replaced. I'm gonna just try to stay away from that glass as much as possible. Alright, well, I hear a survivor down there trying to help us out, but probably not gonna make it too long, I don't think. Wow, it's taking them long enough to even just to get into this place. Look at them go. Okay, so we have a few piled up over there. Do we have any over here? Yep, we have a few on this side. Okay, we're looking not so bad tonight. Oh, there's a survivor right there. Yay, you're fighting the Horde Knight for us? You're the best survivor. I wonder how long she's going to live. I wonder if they're even going to bother attacking her. Since they're coming after me on Horde Knight, since they're feral. I guess we'll have to see here. I mean, they're all kind of really just doing their derpy thing over here, so let's see what happens. We might be able to keep this Horde Knight nice and nice and quiet. That's how I like it. Well, at least on this mod for the first few Horde Knights until we have some good traps and stuff together. Wow, yeah, they still haven't breached the place yet. Looks like I chose a great place to start out here. Survivor's still going at it. I don't think there's any on any other side either. Yeah, no, there isn't. They could actually come through this hole right over here. But they rather choose to bash over on this corner of the building. They're lazy zombies. That's what we got going on over here. So like I said, we're trying to not kill as many, or trying to not kill any tonight. And then we'll take what's left over in the morning and take care of them here. Okay, there we go. Look at that. Did they breach? They broke the window, but they somehow still didn't get in. Wow, these zombies' pathing isn't the best. I wonder if 19.2 did something to the zombies' pathing. Like, it's like, yeah, there we go. Now it's going to try to jump up there, and... Oh, I never even thought about those shells over there. That would probably have been a good thing to take out. Well, we're going to keep an eye on this over here and make sure that they're not going to end up getting up over here. There we go. There you go. Destroy that block, you guys. I don't know what you're going to accomplish by destroying it, but you're also helping me out anyway. Because I'd like to make this all pillars. At least the outside all pillars, so we can at least control the hordes a little bit. Definitely with plates on it. Look at that. These zombies over here are destroying underneath there. Okay, this building's going to last this horde night. This isn't so bad. Looks like we've managed to keep our crap together. These guys here just randomly running around. Oh, yes, please do hit those. I actually need those to come down. No, I don't want you hitting that, so let's see if we can... Whoa! Oh, jeez. Oh, that glass. Guys, I almost felt my heart go into my stomach there. That glass every time. Okay, come over this way, guys. There's a lot of stuff over here that needs to be busted up. Let's see what you do over on this side over here. Okay, so he's trying to get up over there, I think. They're banging on the walls. There we go. I'll use Horde Knight as a renovation night. All kind of just piling up over here. This is funny. So anticlimactic, too. I mean, this isn't so bad. We definitely did put it on 8 max alive, I think. Because this isn't that many. We can definitely handle it. There we go, guys. Keep bashing away. I don't care. Why the corner, though? Seriously, like, I think I still need that corner over here. Yeah, that corner. I don't want you bashing on that corner. I want you guys bashing on the middle of this wall. We need that gone over here. Gotta find a sweet spot, I guess. Maybe towards the outside over here, but then I can't really watch them, and that's not very interesting. Look at them all come running over this way. Okay, there we go. Yeah, they're not doing very much damage to the building anyway, so... Yeah, no, we got this, guys. We got this. What game stage are we here? We are game stage 13, so we're not doing too bad. We're not going too crazy on Horde Knight here. See, I almost wanted to shoot him through. Wow, look at that. How'd he do that much damage that quickly to that block right there? Okay, well, keep my eye out here. Always the corners, guys. Why always the corners? Yeah, there you go. Bust up some of that stupid glass for me. I hate breaking those damn windows out. There we go. Banging on those pillars over there. This is looking good. The zombie demo construction crew over here. Yeah, there you go. Take those out. Whoa. Did you guys just take a torch out on me? Damn it. They took my torch out. Well, I guess you guys can see okay then. I mean, I can see okay, I guess. There we go. Yeah, keep busting that out over there. That lumberjack zombie, he means some business over there. Now, I wonder if these guys are going to kill each other. Whoa. What the heck just happened there? Did you guys see that? That one zombie disappeared. This block blew up and that zombie went flying backwards. Oh, that was crazy looking. Yeah, their pathing is definitely a little funky here after 19.2. But that's okay. I guess it makes things a little easier, if that's okay in your mind. Alright guys, what's up? They act, I think, a little more like zombies. It's a little more erratic, you know what I mean? Instead of being like super smart zombies, knowing how physics work. They just start smashing on things. I kind of miss those zombies, to be honest. Here we go, look at that. This is bashing their way through the building. So I guess these ones right here are just wood blocks. They built these freaking couches out of concrete, but built the outer walls out of wood. Come on, guys. That's funny. That is so funny. At least I know those will be easy to chop out now. I was just taking for granted that the entire thing was made out of wood, and it's not. or made out of concrete, but it's not. There we go. So we got some guys bashing around randomly on this side over here. You guys are doing okay. All right, there we go. So I have no idea what time it is, guys. Like I said, this is much tamer than I thought it was going to be. But I think this is how our first Horde Night worked out last season, too. I was really careful to keep my game stage down. And we didn't have that many zombies to deal with. I mean, every time I kill one of these zombies, it's going to up my game stage. And then it just gets replaced by another zombie. So survivalist speaking, you really wouldn't want to take on more zombies just for the fun of it, especially when you have limited ammo. All we have is 312 arrows. Like, we have some 9mm, I think, back home. But other than that, like, we're pretty hooped for weapons and ammo and crap. There we go. Look at these guys busting this place up. I love it. It's kind of fun to watch, really. That guy's deciding to bust this one up over here for some reason. He's like, I really, really hate that there's a faucet hanging from the wall over here. I'm gonna destroy this stupid thing. Okay, so these guys still busting stuff up. Doesn't really look like they're gonna end up getting up to the second level. They keep going after the windows too, which I really actually appreciate. I mean, they're not a lot of effort to take out, but there's a lot of windows, and they're kind of a pain in the butt. Okay, there we go. So they're taking out windows that way. Let's actually go in the middle here. I want to see what happens when we go in the middle, what they'll do. Okay, so they're piling up on the pillar over there, of course. Piling really isn't exactly what we want. And they're doing a moderate amount of damage to that pillar over there, too. Okay, come over this way, guys. Let's see what happens if you come over here. Come bash at this wall. Yeah, I want you guys to all bash at this wall over here because I need it gone. Still kind of derping out on the corner over there. It's not the corner I want gone. It's the rest of it, guys. Come on. Come on. Jesus, it's like hiring temps over here. So as I see what they're trying to do, they're trying to get us up here. So we'll definitely have to take this out ASAP because that's going to be a way for the zombies to get up to me. Ah, look at this. We got a lab lady in here now. I think they're actually damaging each other, to be honest. I think that's what's going on here. Okay, well, since they're piling up on the corner there, let's see if we can't drag them out over here this way. And get them from doing that, because I really don't want them that high up. Over this way, guys. Come over here. Hello. There you are. What's up, dude? What's up, farmer? Oh, are you going to go for that pillar now? Maybe the corner is the best scent over here. Ugh, right around this sketchy glass. Here we go. Yeah, I'm over this way, guys. Come check me out. Okay, you know what? Just because I'm here, we have time. I mean, I may as well make the most of it, right? And start replacing some of these. Here we go. Copy rotation. Look at me building the horde base on the horde knight. Now, usually, guys, this is not how the way I play. I like to take on zombies. I like to take on the horde knights. But I've played this mod a few times now, and I know better than to really amp up my game stage and stuff before late game, because, oh my god, you get your butt kicked. All right, there we go. So we got that glass replaced. Oh, that was nice. Let's do some renovations over here then. Okay, guys. Well, I think these guys are actually just not really going to do too much damage down there. They've taken out some of the pillars over here. They're continuing taking out some of the blocks, but I don't really think there'll be much of an issue over there. So I'm going to go ahead and bang out some windows here. I do apologize. I thought this horde night was going to be a little more intense. But as usual, I overprepared again. I think what I might do for a series is call it underprepared and just underprepare myself every single time. Going to horde night with a shard of glass or something. I don't even know. I keep like overbuilding like crazy. Just over here renovating with the zombies. You guys doing good down there? Yay, getting all the windows. Thanks, guys. So a little trick I found with these windows here. Now, usually I use a stone hammer with them, but I don't think I had the supplies on me to do it, so I just kind of ignored it. But if you're not using the stone axe, because it's really quick for this, you can punch out this first glass layer, and then take your axe and then punch out the wood after it. I find that works a lot quicker. Alright, an update on our friends here. They keep smashing up on this wall, but I don't think they're going to be able to make a ladder system up to me, honestly. Yeah, like, look at that. They've actually done some damage to the building over there. Oh, we got irradiated in here tonight. Just kind of, I guess, showing up for an early horde night. Okay, and these guys just still bashing at these blocks over here, so we're pretty healthy. I was kind of amped up about this horde night once again. Damn it. Alright, I'm going to continue punching out these windows here. May as well get some stuff done, right? Oh, and there we go, guys. It is morning time. So that was pretty anticlimactic. They did some damage to the building here. They've taken out some of this wall. I've learned, I guess, that this wall is made out of wood. Wow. But we are good to go. I think we could have even done a 64. I mean, this building would have taken a lot of damage on a 64. But I think it would actually still honestly be standing. So that would have been kind of neat to see. Whoa, crap. Well, I guess we're taking on the zombies now. I meant to jump over on the roof and draw them outside. But here we go. I don't think, do we have any ferals? Yeah, actually none of them are running, so what we can do is probably just kite these guys away. Like I said, trying to keep that game stage down, so we can kite these guys away from the base here, because I don't think they're stuck to the base. It's not like it's a POI. Let's bring this guy, I think, all the way over here. There we go. Oh, look guys, fruit. I'm gonna grab that up, and I think those are apples too. Oh yeah, those are handy as hell. Okay, perfect, there we go. And hey, look, there's oranges over here. Taking zombies away, picking fruit, and you guys know how it goes. Maybe a bird's nest or two? Yeah, there's some nice stuff over this way. Okay, so we got the one guy over there, and those zombies, I guess, can just kind of chill out for now. I don't think they're really doing too much. I don't think they're destroying the base or anything, so there's really not too much we have to worry about. And as you guys can see, there's minimal damage to it. There's some holes in the side and stuff. But they did manage to... Whoa, did that one disappear too? These zombies are just disappearing. That's kind of creepy. Yeah, I think they'll disappear in time anywhere, wander off, basically. So let's head back towards the trader here. What did I just hear? That was creepy. Let's head back towards the trader here and get a whole setup back at home. Oh, damn, take a look at this. Our vending machine is restocked, and I don't think we actually have any of our trader coins on us, damn it. I hope I left these behind at home and didn't bring them with us, because, yeah, that's a little bit of a run, and there's probably a few zombies still chilling out there. Not that I don't want to deal with them. Like I said, I'm not afraid of the zombies. I've just learned about game stage with this mod, so, oh, no. It looks like they are all the way over there. That's okay, though. We have until day 13 to buy from that vending machine anyway, so we're all good. Okay, so what do we have here for prepared food? Basically nothing. It looks like we're going to be starving here pretty damn soon. We don't have any of this. So, yeah, I think I left literally everything behind at the old building. Damn it. Oh, my God. I should have brought it all with me here. It's just such a long run doing it that way. It is what it is. Let's head back over and get all of that stuff, damn it. Used up all that energy, too. Okay, here we go. And we're coming back home, and it looks like all of our zombie friends are actually gone. So we have some peace here. Let's check out the building a little bit then if it's going to be quiet. And get right face up to the action here. So yeah, like this whole section here must have been wood. Like look how soft it is. Ooh, that is not good. We're going to have to upgrade this as soon as possible. So they kind of busted out that section over there. They've taken out quite a bit of the windows, which is very convenient. They busted through here. That's hilarious. It's kind of weird seeing how the zombies bust through the building and what they do. And they kind of busted through here. So yeah, they really didn't do too much damage to the building at all. They did a little bit to the pillars over here. This is actually nice. Whoa. I guess that's only 225? Can we... Like, this is concrete right here and that is wood. Like, how is that even fair? You know what? Just because I want to see this thing collapse and we don't get to see it. Damn it. Okay, is a box above it here? Let's get rid of this because this got to go. It's gonna go anyway. And what the heck are we leaning on here? Where are we even attached? I don't understand this. Okay, I'll take a look at that later, but anyway, door is gone. We have no more front door. And yeah, like look at that. Still a lot of stuff left on the floor, like even the fridge is gone. They said, screw you, fridge. But a lot of the stuff is still remaining. That's pretty impressive. Okay, let's check my storage box out here. Make sure I didn't leave anything behind there. Don't need to walk around crouching all crazy-like. Is that our survivor friend over there? Did you survive the horde night, lady? I don't think that's her, but if that is, that's pretty damn crazy. Let me know down in the comments if she survived, because I kind of lost track of her, I think. I assume she died. I mean, that was pretty ballsy to take on Horde's Knight with a melee weapon. Okay, here we go. So let's grab all of our stuff. Yeah, like we have two chicken rations over here. They have 0% food poisoning, and they're actually really good food here. That will get us up another 30. Take care of us. There we go. Look at all of our stuff over here. Damn it, there's so much stuff. I might have to do like a slow crawl back to base here. Oh, I'm gonna have to. Oh, and if we eat one more of these, we should be pretty full. There we go. Awesome. And we have a whole ton of other food on us. Okay, cool. Well, guys, I'll see you in 20 minutes. Holy crap, that took forever, and it sounds like the snipers are going off a little bit, keeping away a few local zombies. Hopefully that wasn't actually a wandering horde. Oh my god. There we go. Okay, so this is going to take me a few moments here, folks. I'm going to go ahead and put all my stuff away here, and hopefully these guys can take care of business. Alright, so we got some zombies on the premises here. I'm hearing banging, I'm hearing clashing, the random gunfire from the traders here. So we really need to take care of that. So I'm going to just dump my stuff here. There's so much to go through. I just don't have the time to do it at the moment. And we got to go and take care of those guys. We can't have them killing our traders and stuff, or killing our traders and our gunmen and whatnot. That's not a good idea at all. But I also can't run at them all super slow, so holy crap, there is so much on me here. Alright, let's go get this done, guys. Wow, I still have too much on me. Okay, let's just go get this done here. Let's go figure out what is going on. What is all this noise about? Whip out our bat and get to business here. What's going on, guys? Yeah, it looks like we definitely have a wandering horde nearby, so I'm going to go outside here and go this way and try to figure out what's going on. Try not to stand in front of these zombies, too. That would not be a good idea. There we go. Like I said, those friggin' guards are like can be like snipers. If you get in the way, it's no fun. Okay, so yeah, there's definitely either respawns from the natural zombies or the zombies around the area. Or this was a wandering horde. I'm leaning, I think, more towards wandering horde, I think. Yeah, there we go. Good. You got them, boys. All right. I think our place is safe now. We can go and, Oh, no. I don't think I found my trader cache here, guys. I don't know where my stash is. I'm going to have to take another look into our storage here. Still got a guy beaten over here. What are you doing? You want a piece of me? Why are you messing up my wall, lady? That's not cool. Hey, look, one of those apple trees are growing, by the way. Alright, so I'm not sure what's going on here, but apparently I've lost track of my my coin stash. Unless I ran out and I'm just forgetting here and being silly. But we have no trader coin, which is okay because we can go and just sell some of this stuff to the trader here. We have so much of it anyway. I'm going to go ahead and actually do that now and get rid of some of our junk. You know, we don't even need that much trader cash, and four of these, I think, will sell for 160 to the trader. So let's go and check that out here and see what it'll buy for us. And I think we do actually want to take a job from the trader as well, so may as well do that. There we go. 160, that'll help us buy some food. Let's see his jobs here. Is it tier 1 fetch? I don't want to do the clear zombies, I think. I want to do the tier 1 fetches. There we go. And where does that bring us? Because then we can use stuff like spikes and whatnot to take out the zombies and help us out. So there we go. Tier 1 fetch literally right around the corner. That's what we'll do here next episode. But for the most part here, guys, I think I've pretty much concluded this one here. We've lost our trader cash. I have to go and sell a few more things to the trader here. We have some stuff kicking around I can get rid of. And then we'll go and buy some food from the vending machine, anything that may be good for us. And go and do that quest over there. It's not too far away. It looks like it's maybe that one right there. Ooh, that's a huge tier one. Anyways, guys, I do hope you enjoyed. If you did, hit that like button. If you'd like to see more, subscribe, and I'll see you guys in the next video. Stay classy, everyone. No matter what you people say, I'm gonna do my thing my way. No matter what you people do, I'm gonna do my thing much better than you. No matter what you say or do, oh boy, you're out of luck. It's gonna roll right off of me like water off the back of a duck. And I go, yeah, I go, yeah, 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 I go. And I go. Good boy.